Hey everybody, it's Dragonic Fire. Welcome back to another Rogue Run. Today's Rogue Run is Isaac. As always, we're doing a challenge today, and we're doing things a little bit differently than what we normally do. But first, let's scroll down to the challenge here. It's been a little bit since I've played this, but we are doing back asswords for our challenge today, and it is a doozy, which is why I'm getting into this recording is a little bit different. I might not react to things as fast as I normally do. Granted, I sometimes react to things slow anyways. As I continue, I basically get hit immediately. So, if I sound a little off, it's because I'm post-recording this, because this challenge sucks. It 100% sucks, and you're going to see why it sucks after we clear this. Because if you're seeing this, it means, like, this challenge was a success. Now, I actually tried this challenge off camera a couple times just for practice, and I failed every one. Like, there was one challenge where I managed to get past this room and then make it down a couple rooms, and then only for me to die because enemies got incredibly too hard. So as you can see, we got some good items. We have Sacred Heart, we got the Black Robes, which gives us Black Hearts, but we were already at max hearts, so we got the damage up instead. We got the... I don't want to say Book of Belial, it's like Eye of Belial or something like that. That basically gives us more damage and gives us piercing. We have Candy Hearts, which gives us stats every time we pick up a heart. We got the keys, we got rocket bombs, where if we shoot and press a bomb, we shoot a bomb. We got the one that shoots out teeth based on luck. The box, which is why you saw so many items pop out, and two items that give us speed, the belt and Mini Mush, which Mini Mush is actually fixed thanks to the thing I'm using, though I think they also fixed it in Repentance. I forget, but yeah, anyways, this challenge takes a lot of patience, and for those that might be wondering why I'm doing this the way I'm doing it, outside of just having failed recorders, like, oh, just record those failed recordings with your live commentary. You don't understand. If you've ever done this challenge before, you'll soon understand why this challenge sucks so bad. Like, I can't even begin to understand what they were thinking with this challenge, assigning just random items and hope you get something good. It is literally a challenge that comes down to pure RNG and how much patience you have with said items. Because if you do not have good damage items, you might as well restart until you get something, like, going. Now, that being said, sometimes even if you have good items, it doesn't always necessarily mean you're going to do well. As you see, I'm randomly getting hit, though I am a little bit rusty with Isaac. Yeah, as you can see, sometimes bad hitboxes, sometimes just being lazy and not predicting what the enemy's movements are. But for the most part, it's not even phase one of Mega Satan that's dreadful, where he summons, like, all the stuff. Though if you don't have damage to keep up with his adds and the sins he summons or the angels, you are going to get royally screwed. It is actually the second form of Satan, which you'll see here in a tiny bit. That hit I got on me was mainly because of my negligence. I was trying to get rid of the hands as fast as possible. Well, we'll get rid of the hands here, and he should be going down pretty soon. First form Satan doesn't have much HP, or at least it seems like he doesn't. Yeah, there he went down, because it's separated into phases. So, here we go. Mega Satan form 2, which is probably the most heinous one of them all. This attack's not so bad, but sometimes some of his attack patterns could be, like, really wily. This one, because it looks like it's shooting out, but it's actually kind of like pulling back and then shooting, and then he'll mix it up. His attacks are a lot of projectiles, so if you get something that can block projectiles, you're, like, golden here. With the fire, you kind of have to, like, it's wavy, so up and down. There is one attack he shoots out, like, right away, and it's, like, dreadful if you're up there. This attack's not so bad if you're in the front, because it basically shoots out, and then once it gets to its destination, it spreads in, like, I think it's a cardinal direction. I'm trying to remember. No, it's diagonals. And as you can see, he likes spamming this attack a lot, which I actually do not mind this attack. I actually like this attack. I think it's here that he does it. Yeah, this fire attack I absolutely hate because I got hit by it twice, as you can see. And I was like, please don't tell me I'm gonna like lose with Sacred Heart. Because this is my best chance at it. And I'm just like praying here at this point. I'm like, please. Like, I don't even care, and I actually did it. Because we have Candy Heart, we gain stats every time we gain a heart out of to recover something. So I'm just sitting here uncovering stuff, trying to figure out what I want. Excuse me. So I pick up two because I know I'm going to encounter or two devil deals, basically. Which I call them devil deals because you're exchanging your heart pieces. Because we are going to need the damage on the way down. Because we might have got past the harder fight, but the hardest fight, but there are still hard fights on the way down. And one of the mechanics of this challenge is like, yeah, you start off with all these great items, but as you go down, you start to lose items. So say like the key piece, you see the key pieces. The next floor we go down, we'll lose one of the key pieces. The next floor down after that, we'll lose another key piece. And then so on and so forth. Until we basically reach the bottom floor, which is the very starting floor. Now, you saw like an aura of light. That's where you have to go to on each floor. Basically, the starting area of each floor. And basically make your way up. Because you are ascending from the very bottom, which is why it starts and the dark room, because basically you're ascending from hell into basically earth, so to speak, or heaven in this case, though you don't actually go to heaven. you're going into hell. Now there are still shops in this challenge, and there are still angel deals, devil deals, whatever you want, so it's not like you're totally screwed and hosed. As you lose items, you'd be like, oh no, I'm losing items. How am I supposed to do this challenge? That's how they expect you to, like, compensate for losing items. So you want to hope, like, one of the items you got was actually, like, something, the first item in the list, not from down below, but from up top. Like, as you could see, the first item I technically had was Mini Mush. You want to hope that say like a damage up was your first item, that way you don't lose it, because it's going to take from the bottom on up, which is pretty good actually. Also, you can see I have Botfly, which is really good. Would have been even better for that fight against Mega Satan, but I didn't have Monster Manual. Oh jeez. Okay. Ugh, excuse me. There's gonna be a lot or whatever. Unfortunately, I forgot to bring myself, like, some water, but this recording's technically not long. I just have to last out. I could probably just have a lozenge or something. In fact, since it is, like, a live recording, it doesn't really matter. I'm back. Some might see this as unprofessional, but live recording, I'll do what I want. Or live recording. When I mean live recording, I'm recording after the fact, or not editing, or whatever. I mean, I can't edit. I could probably edit that part out. It wouldn't really see much of anything, because it's not like I paused the game or anything during this entire thing. I kind of just played. And I'm like, please, just let this challenge be good. And one of the things you'll see is I had a slow shot speed in the beginning, which made it hard for my shots to get there faster. But I actually had a good pill rotation, like a really good pill rotation. I'm not sure if the game takes into account how many times you've lost, like, a certain challenge or runs or whatever. Oh yeah, as you can see, it's spawning on me, which I don't care, because that means more hearts, more stats. Because I've noticed sometimes I'll have, like, crappy pill rotations after crappy pill rotations, and I'm like, come on, game, give me a break. But as you can see, I'm spending, like, a lot of time in the dark room. We're, like, 10 minutes, almost 11 minutes into this challenge, and I'm still in the dark room. Now, if you're looking at the time of this video, it's like close to 30 minutes. Yeah, once I get out of the dark room, I speed up. I speed up immensely. I start going super fast and destroying everything. But I need these items to survive when I eventually get up to the top. Though I end up getting something like really good for later on, as you'll see, which helps immensely when doing these challenges. So we're gonna get out of the dark room now. 11 and a half minutes and we're finally out of the dark room fighting Satan. Now Satan could be another devastating one. He's another somewhat DPS check. It's not like he starts doing weird things, it's more like he'll just be annoying because he does these spreads and I have Bob's brain, which sucks. But yeah, usually you want to try and bait him to shoot down below if you don't have good damage. Then he goes to this last form where he's stomping and I get hit because of Bob's brain, because Bob's brain's amazing. And I managed to survive. I got incredibly lucky. Don't ask why I touched that chest, by the way. It does nothing in this challenge. Probably for luck. I got incredibly lucky there with that fight towards the end. Also, a lot of this challenge, I get incredibly lucky early on with the heart drops. Because this challenge plays off hard mode, which has less drops, especially hearts. Though I feel like normal mode also has less heart drops also, so that's why I don't play normal mode, because I feel like it's a waste of my time. Because most of the things, yeah, I got hurt there. I was like, okay, I need to stop doing this. This is where I'm trying to figure out why aren't the rocket bombs working. And then later on I figure it's like, oh, it's based on if I'm shooting. Which makes sense. I think they actually say that in the description. I know the wiki at least says it. One of the part of the reasons why I got the external descriptions mod was so I didn't always have to look at the wiki for trinkets. Items, after a while, I just kind of figured out or just played enough that I knew. Trinkets, I don't touch enough of them to know what they do, and some of them have very vague descriptions, so. As you can see, we're getting a lot of good stats because of Candy Heart. And the only reason I'm deciding to stay here in, I was gonna say Satan's butthole, is because I wanted a full charge on Monster Manual, as I hurt myself because Bob's brain is good. So this is an item, I think this item is actually part of, whatchamacallit, Repentance. If it's not, it's Afterbirth Plus. Where basically every time you get a kill, it gives you 1 second of vulnerability. So if there's like a lot of enemies, like those little spiders, and you kill them back to back to back, and then go attack other enemies, you can like rack up a lot of invincibility. As you can see, Mom's Heart's pretty easy because of that, even though I should have been hit a couple times. Yeah, I went in there to see if the hole would open up just to be funny, but it's like, no, it's not gonna let us. So I saw some items in there. I could have taken, like, the Book of the Dead just to work towards Bookworm, which is occasionally double shot. But I was like, nah, I like this book and I don't want to waste hearts. I didn't want to, like, chance that I was going to die or something. But anyways, yeah. Now, as you can see, we're in womb 2 and we're 15 minutes in. We are starting to go a little bit faster. I am still exploring a little, even though it is the womb. But right now we have It was a straightaway. And I take the health up pills, even though I know I'm gonna get running spirit hearts because I lose candy heart after this floor, so I basically just want to get as many stats as possible. Yeah. So how has everyone been doing lately? Like, for those that watch, like, these videos or any of my videos or just in general, like, how are y'all doing? Don't really get to ask that all that much when I'm doing these things because I'm trying to concentrate on the challenge. But, yeah. We're on Afterbirth Plus. Yeah, we are. No, yeah. Rebirth, Afterbirth, yeah, this is Afterbirth Plus challenges. Afterbirth, when they start, like, outputting Afterbirth Plus challenges, it started to get, like, ridiculously hard or ridiculously insane. And the fact that it's like, oh, here, have this challenge that you basically have to stand on your head and do a backflip or something. I mean, it's not exactly like that, but it might as well be. Now, as you can see, I took Ouija board mainly for the tears up. Having spectral tears also helps because I have piercing, but yeah. There's a couple other challenges I've done in the past that were hard, but like, Afterbirth Plus onwards, it's gonna be a test of attrition. But that's all I can say. Where I'm probably going to get mad, I'm probably going to do post-recordings like this. So let me know how this goes, if you want me to bring, like, other people to do post-recording, or if you just want me to, like, suffer and do multiple recordings. In which case, I might, like, edit it all together. As I sit there and hurt myself. Yeah, this was me going back. It's like, I'm pretty sure I saw a tinted rock in the middle, and it's like, yeah, it was. Yeah, anytime I go into, like, a separate room that is, of the room where I need to leave from, it means I want to charge my book, and I'm looking at stuff. I go in here because red chests usually have good stuff. Or they could have good stuff, but sometimes, it's not good to gamble. Let's just put it that way. So, what else can I say about this challenge? I actually like the idea of this challenge because basically, not only are you ascending up, but you start with like a random array of items. I just wish it was a bit more, either like more items to start with or more favorable to you. Because I feel like you shouldn't have to restart multiple times until you have a good run. Now I know those that are like, that might not be good at the game. Also, at this point, I lost ceremonial robes. That was what they were called, by the way. I just take that just to get rid of some spirit hearts so I can start earning back. And I saw IBS, and I'm like, I'm out of here. I'm not taking that. The other was the one book that gives you psychic shots, and I wasn't about that because I look up, Monster Manual. Better because it sometimes can summon like good monsters. Sometimes it summon Bob's brain and kill you multiple times. By the way, I took the Fool card from that rock, that skull rock with an X. That is going to come in super handy later. Not that I really need it because it's a very strong run, but because I can. So you might be wondering what Deathless does. If you kill the enemies in the order where the skull is above their head, you have either a chance of getting a stat boost or an item drop. So it's good in that regard. Taking advantage of, yeah, I'm sitting there thinking whether I wanted to take that or not, and I was like, nah, Monster Manual's serving me just fine. As you can see, in smaller rooms, I have like only a couple enemies where I can focus my shots down. It's easier to trigger it. But rooms like this where you have baby pins falling down, mom's hand, everything trying to kill you, it's kind of hard to do. Once again, looking for the charge before I go back up. Because even though I don't need it, I would like to have it going into the boss fight. And I'm sitting here thinking, it was like, what do I want of either of them? There's not many, whatchamacallit. Yeah, I'm also trying not to touch what I don't want. There's not many where I'll sit there and take over the other for the trinket I have now. Yeah, this is what I was saying earlier, why I have such a good pill rotation. And I didn't leave through the door fast enough, so I was like, well, I'm losing this bone heart. Why I went into this room, I don't know, because I was already at max charge. Holy Crown would be good if you're going up, but I'm not going up. I am going up, but I'm not going up in the way it thinks I'm going up. It is kind of funny that you can go to the cathedral after you beat It Lives. But you can also basically go down to hell. So it's like you reach the top of a mountain and it's like, okay, well, you can go up to heaven or you just fall back down to hell past where you came up. That's what it just seems like. Well, it is also like loose Bible references, honestly, in this game, because it does take names from the Bible. But playing this game, I don't really think of that when playing. And I'm pretty sure that's how most people are, because it's a lot of, like, poop and blood humor or whatever. But I just like it as a fun roguelike. Now I'm trying to take advantage of these shops or whatever as much as possible. As you can see, I'm buying the glass eye for the damage and the luck, because I still have the tooth shot. I'm deciding whether I want charge baby or 9 volt. Because I was sitting there reading, it's like, oh, it's every 30 seconds in an uncleared room. So if you're in like a long boss fight, like Hush, it's really good. But like if you're clearing rooms like super fast, like I am doing right now, it's not worth it. So I'm just being careful of what I want to take when things pop up. I just continue to mow down rooms fast because I have, I took damage immediately thereafter because the invincibility doesn't last long if you're not killing things. Shot speed up is really good. So as we continue to move on, these things are really good for activating Death's List. I almost said Death's Wish. That's another game mode in another game. Because you can't kill them from the face, you have to shoot them in the back. I was able to take that mimic chest. Any chests that have like spikes on them, they generally. Oh my goodness. That's adrenaline shot kicking in, by the way. But. Those enemies, they can't be hurt from the front. You have to hurt them from the back. So they're really good for activating Death's List, as I said. Just trying to find the way up as we speak. And as always, I gotta peek my head in there to see what's in there. Because it's like, it could be anything. It could be even a boat. So I always just go in to see what they have. As you can see, we just annihilate things. I just take this so we have guaranteed deals with the devil. Pretty sure we almost had like a deal with the devil every single time. Just taking this for money because it's the last time we get the gold card, which gives us access to the secret shop, which basically is two shops if you think about it. So I want to take advantage of it, even though it could be greed in the shop, but I think the gold card still takes precedence. Meaning it'll still spawn in there. Even though greed's in there. So I'll have a chance at a shop. In case you're wondering, that pills spawned from a mushroom, which mushrooms have a chance of spawning pills and other things. Very easy kill. I am gonna go search for the shop here because I have money to spend and not spending it is kind of foolish. But I am also trying to go fast to not waste people's time. Also, funny number for those that like that. It's very funny when that thing spawns over there. So as you see, the shop's kind of like not worth it, but I do find a couple things down here that I do like. Matchbook gives you a black heart and some bombs with the matchstick. And the other one just gives you a heart and basically activates like the negative and whatnot. So with that, I basically can go up. And he immediately gets nuked off the face of the earth. As you can see, the next thing on the chopping block is Sacred Heart, which we are going to make sure that we have enough damage comfortably, because Sacred Heart gives you a major damage boost. As you can see with those things, it's kind of hard to activate Death's List because they're in your face multiple times. Even though I'm at max hearts, I'm going to activate that just to exchange deals with the devil, because I'm going to need them. But at this point, I'm pretty strong enough that and confident enough that I'm going to get up there regardless whatever I do. Just activating those cards because I can and checking for secret rooms. Also, the way that sounded, that happened because I activated the pill or whatever. It gave me invincibility, which is supposed to play like a little jingle to it. Oh yeah, and at this point I'm just gonna get rid of all my red health. Because that gives me another familiar to tackle things. Even though I could take Potato Peeler. That, I don't know why. I got caught on the square block, or yeah, the square pits, and could not get a move. But yeah, this is why I was saying my pill rotation was pretty good. I only had one detrimental pill in my entire rotation. The rest were really good. Like, the game decided to throw me a bone, and I'm just like, holy crap, like, this is amazing. It's like the best run I've ever had with this challenge. As always, I gotta go check the curse room because I'm always curious what might be in there. Even if it's a waste, like it normally is. As you can see, we're really close because we're in the cellar now. You can tell with the cobwebs and whatnot. Otherwise, it would be a basement. So we'll take the toothpicks. Now, I could take damage up or Book of Belial to guarantee, but at this point, I'm just like, yeah, I'll just keep things along. And it gave me Bob's Brain, by the way, which I absolutely hate because Bob's Brain will get you killed 9 times out of 10 unless you're very patient with it, which I'm not very patient with it. Bob's Brain hates me. I hate Bob's Brain. It's a mutual hate. Now, as you can see, there's nothing of interest there. The one, I think it's fortune card. I forget what it is because I rarely get it. It basically determines at random whether you want to make a... So, the way it takes effect is only in that room, where it'll teleport you to a treasure room, boss room, or a secret room. And as you can see, I just used the full card there, and we win the challenge. So that's pretty much it. So thank you all so much for watching this challenge. And until next time, we'll see you then. Later.